Hi, I'm Sharma Kern with Thai Healing Massage Academy. Welcome to another edition of our Thai Massage question and answer series. Today's question is, when should you use rocking or motion techniques? Now, first of all, I want to say that rocking doesn't just refer to a big rocking movement like that. It can refer to a small movement like a circular movement or even a wiggling movement or a swinging movement. So under the umbrella name of rocking, I include motion techniques. So when is a good time to use those in Thai massage? Scenario number one, you can lead into stretches with them. For example, this here is a twisting stretch for the lower back, and that can be quite intense if you do it directly. In other words, you go right into the stretch and push the leg down. However, if you start out with some rocking moves like this, that takes the sting out of the stretch and you can slowly rock it down. And then if you want, you can follow it up with a direct linear stretch. So that is one good way, and that can be used for many stretches you lead into them with rocking. The second scenario is when a client is sensitive to direct linear pressure. So in other words, you just lean on whatever body part it is, and the client, for whatever reason, is super sensitive. They just can't handle direct pressure. So then you can replace the direct pressure with some kind of a motion-based technique. Little rocking, little circling, or little wiggling, whatever it may be. Anything but not direct linear pressure. And that will generally always work on clients who are very pain sensitive for direct pressure. The third scenario is if your client is really locked up somewhere. Let's say someone has a frozen shoulder and just nothing moves, everything is really stiff. So you can't really force open the shoulder with pressure. Yes, you can apply linear pressure and that will help, but it can also be quite painful if someone is already so locked up. So if you use rocking techniques, you can do this in a more gentle, more effective, and a more elegant way. Let me show you what you can do, for example. You could do a back and forth rocking movement like this with the heel of your hand, or you could do a swinging motion like that. This one is really good because the client can see if their arm moves or not, and you can tell the client, hey, your arm doesn't move, just let go. So you can just visually include this in your therapy. Very, very effective. I've done it many times. So whenever someone is locked up somewhere, instead of working directly on the muscle, it's great to use rocking or shaking or wiggling or circling methods instead, or at least lead in with those methods. The fourth scenario when you should use rocking techniques is just for relaxation, for feeling good. You know, in Thai massage there are many quite strong stretches, and when you do a few of those, then after a while it can just feel a little bit stressful unless you break it up with something relaxing. And rocking techniques are great for that. They can take people into massage heaven. They just feel wonderful. It's like if you rock a baby, the baby stops crying. The baby enjoys it. Humans are the same way. You rock them, it makes them feel good. So whenever you do a series of fairly strong movements in Thai massage, just break it up and do some relaxing rocking technique. For example, this hip technique here is really nice. It affects the entire body. Everything rocks from head to toe. It feels good, very relaxing. So if you want to learn more about those rocking techniques, here at Thai Healing Massage Academy, we have a really excellent online training program, which is called Thai Rocking Massage, which teaches you all possible scenarios where you can apply rocking moves, dozens of techniques to do it with, and it can take your massage skills to an entirely new level.